Hi, mathematicians. Welcome back. Today we are looking at a new unit of study, 1.9, and we are going to be looking at some homework that I share with you here online. So today we're looking at finding the missing number and writing the equation to match the diagram. So first thing is I see a part, whole tape diagram at the top. So 20 is my whole number, and part of that is going to be 14. So I know that 14 plus something gives me 20. Now I can think to find that missing number, 20 minus 14 gives me that missing number. For the next section, it says draw a line on each rectangle that shows halves. So I'm going to look at where this rectangle would be in half. I could split it this way. I could also shade half. I could split it this way and shade that half. Or I could split this long one all the way this way. No, it's still equal half. Like if I had a pizza and I wanted to share it with my brother. Now we're going to use our base 10s to count. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. There are 5 10s. Now let's count the 1s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 ones, so our number is 57. Finally, it says find the missing number and write the equation to match the diagram. What's the missing number? 466. 466. So maybe 400 plus 60 plus 6 equals, that's if we're doing a 3-digit number. Luckily, I'm using an erasable marker. So it wants us to actually make a tape diagram, not a 3-digit number. So it's thinking 400, just a number 4 plus just a number 6 plus just a number 6 gives us what top number? So we're actually missing this top number in our tape diagram. So 4 plus 6 gives us 10. And we know that another 6 plus 10 gives us 16. This one equals 10 plus 6 gives us 16. So our missing number is actually 16 because 4 plus 6 plus 6 equals 16. And if that was a number bond, it's 16 is 4 plus 6 plus 6 equals 16. So mathematicians, today you're going to work on this new set of homework. I'm going to post this blank page on Seesaw if you want to copy it into your math journal. And I'm going to post it on Google Classroom if you want to copy it into your math journal, or you can write directly on it in Seesaw. Have a great day, mathematicians. And again, pay close attention to what I did at the bottom because I was wrong the first time and then I changed my mistake to make it make more sense. Have a good day.